Hello everyone, welcome back. So today we will study about Lord Alfred Tennyson. And if you guys do not know Alfred Tennyson, he is one of the greatest poets of Victorian era, not only of Victorian era but whole English literature. And he is famously known as the poet laureate, and he served the England as a poet laureate from 1809 to 1892, the longest time period any poet has served as a poet laureate. And he became poet laureate after Wordsworth. So that is it. And he is famously known as the bridge between pessimism and optimism. So the first work, which is not so mature work, is Timbuktu. It is first ever published work. He was in school that time, and in school he won Chancellor's Medal for this work, and after that he also became the poet laureate. Now let us move towards the famous work. So the very famous work of Tennyson is The Ulysses, and it shows the Victorian optimism attitude, and it is a story of King Ulysses. It is based on the epic Odysseus by Homer. So now there is a line: I am the part of everything I have met. It is in dramatic, it has dramatic monologue. Penelope, who is his wife, he's sitting with his wife, and he is in his old age now, and he is thinking that it is never too late to start a journey. So he is thinking to start a journey again, and he calls his friends, "Come my friends, it is not too late to seek a newer world. How dull is it to make a pause, to be unburnished, not to shine in use." So basically he wants to go on to travel, and he wants to take a ship journey again, because life is all about adventures. His whole idea is to never be passive but to be active, to do something new. And he is the, like, this text is the apt example of Victorian optimism. There we also came to know about Telemachus. He says, "This is not my life sitting next to my wife." This Ulysses says, because Telemachus and his wife Penelope, they are sitting together. Now let's come to the next poem, which is Lotus Eaters, and it published in 1842, and the source of this poem is Homer's Odyssey. Now it is again a part of Ulysses. Ulysses found an island where he is lost, and all of his friends are lost, and here he has glorified death. He says, "Enjoying the life should be the aim of life. They all are half drowsy. They eat lotus like object, like indolence is life." And people say that this lotus is an intoxicated thing which they are eating. Anyways, because they are very much drowsy and very much lethargic, in a sluggish mood. So they say, "This is not life. We have a duty. Death is the ultimate reality." So this is a very laid back kind of poem. Now let's come to the another work. This is Tithonus, and here Tithonus is a shepherd. He wants to be immortal. We see use of dramatic monologue here, and if you're wondering what is dramatic monologue is one-sided dialogue. Like, there is only one person who is speaking and every others are listening. So that is known as dramatic monologue. And Tithonus is 400 years of age because he wanted to live long. So by mistake, he asked for a wish that he wants to live long. And you won't believe, he was 400 years old. He was not able to walk properly. He is crawling, and that is a mistake he has done. He should have also asked for the young age. Anyways, we should not long for anything that is against nature, simply for human life. So now let's come to In Memoriam, 1850. Now, it is an elegy on the death of his dearest friend Arthur Henry Hallam. It is not a pastoral elegy. He took 17 years to complete this poem. Also has these poems inside it. Break, break, break. This is an example of objective correlative. Waves are also angry. Protagonist is in pain. So objective correlative is like, if you are feeling the pain, the whole universe is feeling the pain. That is objective correlative. Like if you are in dilemma or you are sad, so you will see that nature is also sad, or it is raining someday and you are feeling very gloomy and sad, then you say, okay, the weather is also sad. So that is known as objective correlative, where you correlate with the nature or the surroundings around you. Now comes Tear Idle Tears. Then there is a poem, it is Morte de Arthur. It is also called Idylls of the King. And this talks about the Arthurian style, Arthurian cycle, the 24 round table and the chapters where we learn about the adultery of Guinevere and Lancelot. So this is it. Then comes Passing of Arthur, where he mentions the Arthur's death, and it is very tragic poem because here he talks about the adultery and the deceiving nature of behavior which Arthur received from his beloved wife Guinevere. Now comes Defense of Lucknow, and this happened during the mutiny of 1857. And he is just making fun of the Indian Lucknow Revolution. So that is it. Then comes how they brought her warrior dead. Talks about heroism. Then Locksley Hall, Christian Love Among the Church. Talks about the Christian belief and process. Now comes Lady of Shalott. I think many of us have already read Lady of Shalott because it was prescribed in the undergraduate courses in many of the university. Then comes Maud and Other Poems, Queen Mary Drama, The Princess. It deals with the freedom or push, like the freedom of the women basically. So yes, this is it. This was a really small capsule, things, important things about Tennyson. If you want to see anything in detail, so make sure to comment below, and I hope this is helpful. Make sure to like and subscribe this channel.